So how do you connect up devices that were actually made before the Internet of Things? With this little guy. So this is the Naran push. There's really no way to describe it but to say that it's a robotic finger. It's designed actually to go ahead and connect up light switches and other switches that were actually, you know, in place before things began connected and began connected and wired and so forth. So here's sort of the way it works. Take a light switch like this, for example, and you have one finger on this side and one finger on that side, and you simply activate them back and forth. Now, here's how you do it. This is connected to a smartphone by way of Bluetooth low energy, and you can simply go ahead and identify which switch is which. So you can have a switch identified as, say, the living and right switch, or the coffee maker, or even the stereo system and so forth. Simply tap the button and the device turns on. Now, the problem, of course, is that with something like this, you can see there's two fingers. One turns it on, one turns it off. If you have something like, a switch like this, for example, you can turn the switch on, but unless you have a switch on the other side, it's not going to turn off. So that's a problem. These devices are actually $49. They're $49 each. They have about enough battery life to last about a year with about 10 switches per day. I have to admit, they look a little bit clunky. They look a little bit funny. My first thought in seeing something like a robotic finger was that, you know, I would attach it to the outside of my windshield and, give the finger to somebody who's cutting me off on the highway. But, you know, okay, they're somewhat practical and they're useful. And you know what? If you have a light switch and you don't want to actually use a clapper, this is the thing to have.